We all know that the core of the computer is the CPU, and the essential of the CPU is almost like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, and these are realized by addition. So today we will talk about how the computer implements the most basic operation, addition. Now, how do you add 245 and 673 in decimal? First, we need an addition table. Then, according to the corresponding position, starting from the 1th place and add up to 8. Then the 2nd place, and so on. This is very simple. What about binary? Similarly, we also need a binary addition table, which is addition part of 0 and 1. And then change the decimal 2 to the binary 10. Finally, the unity is written in 2 digits. Next, split the 2 bits. The right side is called the addition bit, and the left bit is called carry bit. With the help of these 2 tables, let's add 2 binary digits together. The first is 1s and 0s of the 1s place, and by using the table of addition bits, the result 1 is obtained. Then use the table of carry table to get the 0 carry. Then calculate the left digit. By analogy, the calculation is realized by looking up the table. Then how to realize the lookup table? The first is the carry table. If 1 becomes true, 0 becomes false. That is, it is true when both inputs are true. This equals the AND gate in the logic gate. For example, if we input 0 and 1, the output is 0. If there are 2 1 inputs, then the output is 1. It is equivalent to checking the carry table. The addition table is very similar to the OR gate, except for the lower right corner. And if the AND gate is reversed, it becomes an AND gate, which is quite similar, except for the upper left corner. So can you combine these two in turn? 0 and 1 become 0, 1 and 0 become 0, and the others are 1 and 1 become 1. Then you can use the AND gate, connect them together, and this whole is called exclusive OR gate. Now we can use XOR gates and the AND gates to realize the output of the addition bit and output of the carry bit, respectively. Put them together, called a half adder. If there is another input 3 submission, it becomes a more complicated full adder. Here, input 3 is the input of carry. Specifically, first use a half adder to add the input 1 and input 2 of this bit, and output the addition bit and the carry bit. Then the readout of this bit is input with the carry of the previous bit, and then the half adder is used. The addition and the carry bits of the final standard are output. Then input the output of the 2 carry bits into the OR gate and output it as the carry output of the next one. Then why not use a half adder here? Let's look at the largest input first. That is, all of them are 1. The addition bit is 0. The others are like this. Then the input of the OR gate will have 0. So the traversal will find that the OR gate is enough. This is the full adder. Okay, now use the full adder to calculate the binary addition. First, calculate the first column from the left. Take 1 and 0 as input. There is no carry here, so the carry input is always 0. Then the addition bit 1 and the carry bit 0 are output. Then there is the second column, and another full adder. The carry 0 of the previous bit is used as one of the inputs and then output. By analogy, we can get a 4-bit 2-stage adder composed of 4 adders. There are 2 4-bit binary inputs, 1 output, 1 carry bit, and 1 carry output. In the case of 2 8-bit adders, The low 8-bit carry output is used as the high 8-bit carry input. It can become a 16-bit adder. Well, we actually only use logic gates such as AND gates, XOR gates, and OR gates, and they can be composed of transistors, such as this triode. When the computer implements complex calculations, it is actually only opening and closing the circuit. This video is here, and we will see you in the next issue.